Hi, today I'm going to show you what you need to bring during a day of hiking on the summer together with us at Uteguiden. I will start with what we have on us and then what we will have in the backpack and what's nice to bring some extra stuff on top of that. So we start from the bottom and up. So first a pair of sneakers. Or this is like more of a mountain trainer. Important that you don't have a flat sole on it, then it's going to be really slippery, especially if it's wet. If you have more of a hiking boot, that's totally fine too. I use both of them, and we will go through a little bit more of different boots in a later chapter. Socks, I like wool in general. Wool is warmer than synthetic, and it will keep you warm even if you get wet. So one pair of wool socks. This one smells like they have been out on some hiking before, so take clean socks, that's nicer. And then I have a pair of pants. Normally I use like a softshell pant like this. This is not really wind or water repellent, but it's just like a nice pant for hiking during the summer, with some, yeah, as you can see, some nice pockets on the sides, and yeah, just a great pant. Don't use like jeans in general, could be really warm, so try to have a pant with some space in it, and if it's a little bit thicker, just see if you have some zips on the sides so you can open it up. And then I have a woolen t-shirt like this. Again, wool will be better than synthetic, and it won't get cold if it's wet. As you can see, I'm a big fan of blue, which is nice. Here I have a wind jacket on top. This is like similar material to the pants. It's not wind or water repellent, but it's warm enough for summer hikes. And in general, like, this is a light one, easy to open up and to get some wind in it if it's getting warm. On the top, I have a cap. A cap works perfect for sun, rain, all kind of weather. Of course, I have my Uteguiden cap, which you find in our web shop with a link below. Also in blue. That's about it, what I'm starting with, at least on me. And in the backpack, I mean, in Norway in general, the weather is really shifting. We often get questions about how's the weather in June or how's the weather in July. And changing is the most prominent thing about the weather here. So you always have to dress for all kind of weather. So in my backpack, I have a water repellent jacket. This is a thin and light one, which I think is really nice, because then I can easy put it into my backpack without that it's taking too much space. I also have a Gore-tex pant for those rainy days, also in my backpack with me. I mean, remember to always check the forecast. If the forecast says rain the whole day and a big sun, then I maybe drop these two, but remember to check the forecast. I also like to have another woolen shirt. This is a long sleeve, perfect to have something to change when you come up to the top or the end of the end of the uphill and are supposed to start going downhill. So then I can change over to a dry wool sweater. This is a really nice one from Live a Little, which I've been using a lot lately. This fellow is more or less always with me. Primaloft jacket. Also, like Primaloft is better than down because it works better. If it gets wet, it won't get destroyed. And this one is also really easy to, it warms a lot and I can pack it into like a pretty small pack like this. You see, we're keeping on the blue theme here. A bandana or a buff like this one, perfect to either have on your head if it's getting cold, over the neck, and yeah. And I mean, this one won't take any space at all in your backpack. I have a wool hat. This is a thin one. Perfect. A lot of people use these ones under the helmet during the winter too, just because it's so thin. Perfect for biking in cold weather and for hiking. If we are in the end of the season, or like in the fall or early in the spring when it's a little bit colder, it could be nice with a long john like this one. Here's the classic zip long from Northern Playground. So it's a long john with full length zip, so you're actually able to take it both like on and off while you're out hiking. So I just take down my pants, put on the zip longs, and when it's starting to get too warm, it's easy to take it off again. Also in wool. And these ones you can also find in our web shop and in both our offices in Ålesund and Stranda. A pair of thin gloves. I mean, it's some of the mountains we are hiking on around here are pretty high, which means it could be pretty cold even during middle of the summer. So a pair of thin gloves could be nice. I have some water with me. Of course, food too, some sandwiches to eat. That's totally up to you what you want to bring. If it's sunny, sunscreen and sunglasses. I like sunglasses that have good ventilation, just so I can have them on even if I'm starting to get sweaty without fog on the inside of them. And if you have some extra space in your backpack, it could be nice with this one to sit on. I normally just use my backpack, to be honest. I'm just sitting on the backpack, but this one is really thin and fits very well in the backpack. And on top of that, we have some things that's nice to have, but not what you would need to have if you're joining us for a guided hiking. So if you're out there on your own, and this is what the guide normally has with them on a guided trip with us. So this is a shelter or a windbag that's will fit two persons perfect if we come up in bad weather, if someone gets injured, and something I always have in the bottom of my backpack. First aid kit. And which first aid kit you need to choose is something we will go through in some later videos. But just in general, like try to bring what you think you need, and have a first aid kit that's not too big. I also like to bring some extra stuff so I can if someone get injured or a backpack breaks or whatever, some stuff to repair it. Headlamp, also like small and doesn't take too much space. I mean, in general, we want to have as little things as possible with us. GPS, if you don't have your, I mean, your smartphone will most likely work really good as a GPS too, and you have some watches too you can use. I normally, if I'm out on longer trips, I will use a GPS like this because the batteries will hold for longer time and it's easy to change the batteries and I don't need to have a battery pack with me for charging the phone. A map over the area you're going in, and a compass. This one runs without batteries at all, so it's even better to bring with you than the GPS. I used to have like a small dry bag with me where I could put the extra clothes I have with me. It's perfect to put in the backpacks. I know they will stay dry if it starts raining. And if you don't have a dry bag, it works perfectly fine with a normal plastic bag, but just something that could withstand some rain at least. And then maybe the most important, a camera. If you don't want to use your smartphone to take photos with, I often have a camera like this with me. It takes really little space and the quality on the photos is really good and it's really fun with some great memories. And here I have a telescopic pole that I can easily put together so it fits down in my backpack. This is perfect for both like downhills and uphills. To support your knees a little bit, and then you won't get as much pressure on your knees. And all this I have today, I have this backpack from Saleva with me. It's called Guide. It's 35 liters, so this is pretty big. In general, for hiking during the summer, it will probably be just fine with like 20 or 25 liters, but it depends a little bit if you're bringing your own backpack or if you have one for the whole group or whatever, but like 20 to 25 should be just enough for a day of hiking. So we're really looking forward to get you over here to us in Norway and out for some hiking. Cheers.